Hey, back again, Math 1. We're looking at number 2 on practicing the basics transformations. Number 2 says rotate the triangle ABC 90 degrees counterclockwise. Now let's talk about what that means. When you rotate an object counterclockwise, just imagine a clock. Here's your center of the clock. And if you rotate counterclockwise, that means you're moving in this direction. See my arrows? Not a very good diagram, but that's the direction you're moving. This direction. That's counterclockwise, okay? That would be counterclockwise. Clockwise is this direction. And that would be the direction. Okay, so we're going to be moving counterclockwise. Let's keep that in our mind. And it says we're moving counterclockwise about the origin 0, 0. Label this new image A double prime, B double prime, C double prime, and connect each anchor point with arcs using a compass. I will not use a digital compass on this activity. When I am back on Wednesday, we will show you how to use a compass. List the new coordinates here. Now, I've been listing my new coordinates on the diagram, but I'm erasing the previous diagram, so you should list your coordinates where it says to list them here. Okay? Now, let's go back to the diagram. Let's rotate this at 90 degrees counterclockwise about the origin. Now, the origin is 0, 0. And that's called the center of rotation. Let me say that. That's what that's called, center of rotation. And so now what we do is, let's pick a point. Let's pick a point here. And let's say I start with point C. So from the center, let's try that again. From the center to point C, I want to rotate this 90 degrees counterclockwise. And so do you remember the direction of that? And that direction was this way, right? It was that way. And I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. Does that make some sense? So what occurs is that now when you rotate that 90 degrees, you want this angle, this given angle, to be 90 degrees. And so here's what I see. Going to be right here. Oops. A little tricky here. Let me zoom in. There it is. So that is your 90 degree rotation. I didn't use a compass. And my new coordinate would be parentheses positive 7, comma 8. Okay? And that point is now C double prime. Now, let's rotate this point here 90 degrees. Okay. So, that is now going to be Mind you here. Right here. That is 90 degrees counterclockwise. And that point is A double prime. And finally, I guess I can write the coordinates down too. And finally, the last point. So this last angle right here is 90 degrees. Now, that was pretty darn complicated, that whole process of rotating that 90 degrees. But that's the procedure, and again, we will talk about this in more detail tomorrow when I'm in class. But you can see the 90 degree angles by looking at the connecting line segments from the center of rotation to each of the pre-image points onto the new image points. It does create a 90 degree angle. So I hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.